caravan rolling through strong. We got legends in the building. Jimmy's Famous Seafood as we make our way towards another. We're spoiled around these parts because of these fellas. Another Ravens playoff game. We're here at Jimmy's, joined by Dannelle, Ellerbe, and Lardarius Webb. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Nice.
Dannelle, let's start with you, my man. Let's start with you. Linebacker position. Looking at this crew right now, with Patrick Queen and Roquan Smith, guys feared you. Guys feared your crew 2012. It was one of those games, if they played against you and your guys, it was a win if you can, survive if we let you type mentality. And this year, Agent Zero, Roquan Smith, Queen, it really feels like that Ravens defense of legend yet again, where teams look at and go, God, we hope we make it out of this game alive.
Yeah, we got a great tandem of linebackers, the best in the league. You got two all-pro linebackers, sky's the limit. And you got Roquan being mentored by Ray Lewis, so I already know the type of tools you're going to have with the guys and them.
Scoot that right up there.
Oh, my bad.
There you go, bud.
All right, could they hit me?
There you go.
Yeah, so sky's the limit for him. And, I mean, for him to be mentored by Ray Lewis, be that close, sitting in proximity with Ray Lewis.
Ooh, hold on 1 second. Hold on. Get a little turn up over there. Get a little turn up. Got a couple of guys. Huh? How turned up?
Got some dogs.
Yeah, okay. We got some dogs. Okay.
Georgia Bulldogs. So yeah. I got to rub that in his face every time.
Because that was one of the things that we were saying about going to this game with a guy like C.J. Stroud. You know, you take him out of his element. You have him run out of the pocket. That was always the secret with your crop of Ravens, especially taking on Brady. Brady was a guy that if he was in the pocket, he was going to get it done. But then you put the pressure on him, you take him out of his comfort zone, and that's when mistakes were made. That's when New England would fall apart against the Ravens in a playoff scenario. You took him out of his comfort zone. I think that's the key tomorrow with C.J. Stroud. The guy is poised in the pocket, but you got him running for his life. Mistakes are going to get made.
Yeah, you got to push him off the spot. The interior D lineman, they got to get him off the spot, blitz up the middle, and get him running, get him on the run. And
you want to borrow my mic?
Yeah. The swap headsets with him real quick. There we go. Troubleshooting on the fly. Kobe, head over to that bartender and get a quadruple Jack and Coke for me. Appreciate it, pal. Appreciate that, pal. Also, Lardarius Webb joining us here at Jimmy's Famous Seafood. We were saying earlier, yes, that's
there
right.
We go.
Give it up for the man. Give it up for the man. We were talking earlier about health at this time of year, that you go to the playoffs, you go to the postseason with the players you got. Not everybody ends the season with the players that they start with. How does a team, you know, from your time playing, you know, how do they process injury? How do they get over that? There's always been that next man up mentality with the Ravens.
I think with Baltimore, that's the main focus during the offseason is those backup guys, where we already know the first 22 is going to be there and they're going to know and do exactly what they need to do. But for us, it's about the healthiest team is going to make it to the playoffs. The healthiest team will win the Super Bowl, not really the best team. It's the team that,
healthiest
that has the most guys that's still on the field. And for us, it's always that next man up. So that's how Harbaugh trains you. He trains you in training camp with those backup guys are going to know just as much as the starters. And once that happens, then, you know, it don't matter who goes down. Just like Likely came back in and just replaced Andrews, it's other guys on the sideline that's ready and prepared to do the same thing if a starter goes down. That would make Baltimore special. It's because when preseason starts, our backup guys has the same amount of reps that the first team has. So if they got 1,000 plays in preseason, The backup got 1,000 plays also, because that's how we do. It's called double downs.
Yeah.
You'll learn about them.
They're ready to go.
They're ready to go.
And you talk about what makes Baltimore special. How about John Harbaugh? I mean, he's been with this team for 16 seasons, and it seems like he hasn't really changed from what you guys knew of him and obviously were under him to what he's been like coaching now and what you've been seeing of him with this younger team. What do you make of that?
I've been here since 2009. Harbaugh got in 2008. Mm-hmm. I think he's changed a lot. I mean,
he's evolved.
Tremendously. Yes,
he's evolved.
Oh, man. When he first got here, he was real stern. You know, he was hard on us, you know, because he had a veteran squad. He had Ray Lewis and Ed Reed and Haloti and all the other guys. But throughout the years, he got better and better as a player's coach. Like, we started to fall in love with him because he understood us. At first, he was just trying to put his foot down.
Yeah.
We're going to follow him
assert
no matter
dominance.
What. Yes, that's
yeah.
what he was
he's
doing.
He's in a room full of alphas. He's got it.
And that's what he did. But now he's becoming that, well, he understanding us a little bit better. And that's just respects to him.
How do you feel about Travis Kelce and Taylor Swift just taking over? They're just it seems like they're ruining everything.
Adding to the game or distracting from the product.
Exactly.
I feel like they add into the game, you know, if they're trying to reach this market that they haven't reached yet, you know, but Taylor Swift can bring them that market. Just hopefully he lose this week and they can go home, because they don't need no new fans.
That's true.
Taylor Swift can keep her fans, but I understand what they're trying to do, and it seems to be working.
Do you think it's I don't want to say rigged, but it's like sort of an arranged thing?
Do you think it's an arranged relationship?
It's for PR.
Yeah.
Like some power people got together in a boardroom and be like, all right, the Tony Romo, Jessica Simpson thing didn't work out, but we got another idea. We take Swift. We take Kelce. We breed them.
I don't know, but
I wouldn't doubt it. I wouldn't doubt it. I'm
gonna
ride with y'all. I wouldn't doubt it.
Thank you.
I mean,
thank you, Dannelle.
I wouldn't know. I feel like it's part of the marketing scheme. I don't think it adds to the game, but it's part of the marketing.
You wouldn't trade places? Like,
no.
I'm just asking. I was asking for a friend. I was talking about Taylor Swift.
Does I know.
Nothing for it.
Dannelle, let me get back to something Lardarius was talking about, having that next man up, that double down. How important is it, the strength and conditioning, coaches and staff of a team, to keep people almost sort of like, let me compare it to a pit crew in NASCAR, keeping that machine oiled up, readied up, fueled, ready to rock, to having somebody in the strength and conditioning department of the Ravens to keep these players healthy and active? I feel like sometimes there's not enough of a light shined on that crew, and the Ravens got a great one. There were some changes recently over the past few years. Harbaugh got rid of a long-standing member of the staff and moved on from that, and now the team is, for the most part, healthy, upright. Andrews on his way back. He did lose Dobbins for the season. That was a shame. But how important is that strength and conditioning division?
Since our rookie year when we first came in, Harbaugh plans this team to win in December. He always talk about you want to be rolling in December, January, the end of November. So that's how the training camps were. The training camps was brutal. I mean, they got it a lot easier now. So,
yeah.
But you can parlay that into the weight room. So we always lift after practice. Like, guys got to take it serious. Like, you can lift all the weights in the world, but injuries are a part of football.
Yeah.
That's why the next man up situation is.
Have they ever had to, like, slow a dude down? Like, whoa. You don't need to be repping out 250 for 15. You're going to rip them shoulders up. What's the old
Never.
Adage? It's easy to slow down a fast horse than speed up a slow one?
Never, because different guys work out different ways. Everybody is not. Don't have the same kind of regimen. So
different
some guys
types.
More stability and just maintenance. Some guys got to go in there and lift heavy. So,
got it.
And you talked about really peaking at the right time. Here we are in January. I asked this to Justin Tucker, so I asked you guys, what similarities or characteristics do you see from the Super Bowl 2012 team, Super Bowl 47, to maybe this championship caliber team here in 2023, 2024?
What I see the guys confident. It's a confidence in just being lax, but not like lackadaisical, but like lax.
Right.
Confident, just know you can go out there and get it done, and going out there and having fun. The biggest part.
Do you see inside the locker room that, like, the energy is the same?
Well, yeah, that's what I see. I see, like, they're so close. It's like they're real tight. You can tell. I know they be celebrating and running down to the end zone, but it's just like how they do it.
The camaraderie.
You can just tell from being in the locker room that, yeah, those guys, they really like each other. They're not just out playing football and you play a position. But, no, I like playing alongside you.
These guys are brothers.
Yes, they are.
Because how much does the outside, when you guys are bonding, if you're going to breakfast, dinner, whatever it may be, like weekend stuff together during the bye weeks, how much does that translate onto the field? They're getting to do that this year.
Yeah, they are. But also Mike McDonald, you know, where Mike was, he was like the DB. He was like a cornerback assistant.
Yeah.
You know, always been a great guy, smart, great at what he does. But we have to give him something, you
Absolutely.
Know, because that how that defense is bonding. He's telling them something to make them feel confident, believing in one another, playing fast. So I'm always going to take my hat off to Mike, and I think he's doing a great job.
And I'll say this before we get out of here. We're about to jump, get to Josh Spiegel's news. I know you gentlemen got a busy day. You want to get back to Super Bowl 47? I was there. I was in the dome. They turned the lights out on you guys.
On purpose.
I know for a fact.
Yeah.
I know for
it
a fact.
It was rigged.
That was too much of an ass whooping. They didn't want it. They did not want that to go the
way
it was.
A lot of people
are
going to lose money.
There was 15 people. 15 people on that ESPN dais, 13 of them which picked San Fran. Someone was like, no. This can't happen. Go pop a breaker. The Ravens are getting too deep between them butt cheeks. I know for a fact.